Dear viewers, I hope you are all fine. This ultrasound video shows a rare case of uterine dystrophies with the cyst in the cul-de-sac. You can see the unibladder and a cyst is seen in the posterior cul-de-sac. Uterine dystrophies is a disorder present before birth in which a female develops two uteruses instead of one. It results due to the failure of the Mellorian duct fusion that occurs between 12th and 16th week of pregnancy. Uterine dystrophies is a type of Mellorian duct anomaly class 3 where there is a complete duplication of uterine horn as well as duplication of the cervix with no communication between them. Now you can see the uterus. This is the uterus. And this one is the cervix and this is a cyst. And this is the cyst seen in the posterior cul-de-sac of the both uteruses. Now you can see both the uteruses. Again you can see the cyst, uterus, one uterus and the unibladder. Normally women with two uteruses do not have problems getting pregnant, but in some cases it might be harder and there is an increased incident of fertility issues. Now you can see both the uteruses and these both cervix and hemorrhagic cyst is seen in the cul-de-sac. When a female fetus is developing in the intrauterine life, two small tubes called Mellorian ducts come together to form her uterus. If the Mellorian ducts do not come together completely, this can cause problem with the uterus, including now there are some types of the uterine anomalies. You can see both the uterus and the cervixes. Now the anomalies of the uterus are septated uterus. This is the most common congenital uterine anomaly, abnormality. Here in these cases, a band of muscle or tissue divides the uterus into two sections. This condition can cause women to have repeated miscarriages. Surgery may be done to repair the uterus and reduce the risk of miscarriage. Now the other anomaly abnormality is bicornuate uterus, also called heart-shaped uterus. In these cases, the uterus has two cavities, spaces, instead of one large cavity. Most women with this condition do not need surgery to repair it. Now, another abnormality called Didelphus uterus, as you are seeing in this case, is also called double uterus. In these cases, there are two small separate cavities, uterine cavities, each having its own cervix openings. As you are going to see in this case, two uterus, two cervix. Now another abnormality that is called unicornate uterus, also called one-sided uterus. This condition happens when only half the uterus forms. Surgery cannot make the uterus any larger. Now uterine dystrophies typically shows two widely spaced uterine corpora, each with a single fallopian tube. Separate divergent uterine horn with large fundus cleft is known as septate uterus. Now a double uterus often causes no symptoms, as in this case. The condition may be discovered during a regular pelvic examination or during imaging tests to determine the cause of the repeated miscarriages. Women who have a double vagina along with the double uterus may initially consult a doctor for menstrual bleeding that is not stopped by a tampon. Now, a bicarnuate womb is heart-shaped. Women with the bicarnuate womb have no extra difficulties with conception or in early pregnancy, but there is a slightly higher risk of miscarriage and preterm birth. It can also affect the way the baby lies in later pregnancy, so a cesarean birth might be recommended. You may have been shocked to know a case that was reported, 33-year-old Californian woman birthing octuplets in January 2009, and until that is, there was a news of a woman with two uteruses who pooped two babies, one from each womb. The mother, dubbed Womber Woman by the New York Post, delivered two baby girls at a hospital. According to the Mining Journal, the twins were 7 weeks premature and underweight, one weighed about 3 pounds, 15 ounces, that is about 1.8 kilograms, and the other was 4 pounds, 15 ounces, that is 2.2 kilograms, but doctor told the newspaper that both the babies and their mother were doing just fine after their cesarean section delivery. Again, you can see both the uteruses having their own cervix, plus you can see the unibladder and a hemorrhagic cyst in the cul-de-sac. Most women are not aware they have a condition until they become pregnant and get an ultrasound examination, a test that uses sound waves to produce images of the inside of the body. If she gets an ultrasound about 8 weeks into her pregnancy, as is usually recommended, chances are the ultrasound technician would spot the extra womb. But if womb doesn't get an ultrasound until 20 weeks or more into her pregnancy, the uterus housing the fetus might have grown big enough to overshadow the extra uterus, in which case the ultrasound technician might not see and the woman may never know about the double uterus she is having. Again, you can see the hemorrhagic ovarian cyst. Both the uterus and uterine dystrophy are in the same place that a single uterus would be, in the pelvis, right behind the bladder and in front of the rectum. Assuming that woman is not pregnant, the twin uteruses take up about as much as space as a single uterus, which is about the size of a pear. Together they resemble a Valentine's heart, each having a round top and tapered bottom. So if you cut the heart down the middle, each side would look like a uterus. Normally, women with two uteruses do not have problems getting pregnant, but in some cases it might be harder. You can find some important information in the description of this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe my channel. If you do like this video, please click the like button. Thanks.